minutes before it becomes after 2 minutes we say good afternoon. And thank you, dear lady, for all your good words about me, which I dedicate to my people and accept with all humility, which rather will make me more responsible for doing something better for the society. Dear Professor Nair, Professor Rado, Madam Alexandra, Professor Das, distinguished dignitaries of the dais, delegates. My greetings to all of you from my company, Energy Limited, where I happen to be a first quarter. And the friends, when we talk of organization, essentially we talk of people. And when we talk of people management, essentially we talk in terms of managing the diversity. Diversity to align with, to find a common core to contribute to the purpose of the organization. And the diversity management is about the harnessing all the differences that come with people coming from various backgrounds, maybe the linguistic, maybe the regional, maybe the gender and the sex, maybe coming from the ethnic perspective, maybe the views and differences they carry with them. So day in and day out, we find ways to manage all the diversities, to run a smooth organization, to achieve effectiveness, and to harness the people potential. And managing diversity is a continuous and a very challenging process. And here, we will be focusing on the gender diversity. Gender diversity, in fact, not only is a perception, but it is a fact that we grapple with in our day-to-day life, in dealing with various things happening in the society, and organization is no different. We heard about the international perspective, the numbers of representation of women in the workplace, in the corporate boardrooms, and India is no different. In fact, in India, though we have many instances of many great women doing many good things, doing things differently, and they rose to the top, still we find, in general, all these exceptions really don't give us the satisfaction that we have a good representation of women. And the society as such, in general, the mindset that prevails is not allowing women to come out so strongly to occupy various positions because of the background and the history of our society that we have gone through. In the ancient days, if you recall, those who made the threats, Gargi and Apala in the field of learning, along with the Vedic times and the Odysseus, they made the difference in the field of learning. We talk of Mother Teresa, we talk of Helen Taylor, they made a great difference. We really respect them. And even the days Jhansi, the Rani of Jhansi during the war, we adore and admire her. And today in the business world, we have many ladies doing very well. In the case of Nishi Vasudeva, the special lady, and now in the private field, Kiran Majumdar of Biocon. And then we have in the banking field, Arunji Bhattacharya, Sandhan Gocha, so many ladies are there. They have made it to the top, not because we wanted or we gave a protectionism to them because of their competence and efficiency. They have very little talk. But those cases are very few, and we are able to count it. Maybe in the initial phase, even our the norms in the society really did empower ladies to come to the business front, come to the work front. Traditionally, we all believe that yes, a lady can be, or is a mother, is a sister, is a wife, is a good homemaker. And we adore a lady in all her roles. But somehow, when it comes to a lady taking up a job, doing a vocation, going out and doing something different, there perhaps the male chauvinism comes. That acceptance has to be there. Perhaps the mindset that we have towards a working woman, that has to undergo a change. So over the years, it really did happen that many women were encouraged to accept a job or work in public domain. And there are some religious, like if you take the international and the, and I'm not criticizing a religion as such, but women are not, like a Muslim religion, they're not very empowered to do things other than what have been prescribed for them by in the norms of the society. With that background, the education of girl children are not encouraged. And in fact, a girl child is not welcome even at the time of the birth. So these mindsets have to change. And today we find girls are no inferior. Rather, there are areas in which they're much better. Much better in the sense that the difference in ability is that, let us acknowledge the difference. Difference in vision, difference in the abilities, that is that. But there are some areas where the really surpass the men, coming to the taking care of both the sides, the family front as well as the career front. They do a lot of compromise, and when we rate them and assess them, we really forget the sort of sacrifice they are doing, the sort of extra burden or the extra talent they are putting in. So these are the things we will have to look into so far as the management is concerned, and the perception. Perception about the ladies have to change. Even in the family, we adore the lady in all its forms, as a mother, as a sister, as a daughter. Why not? The same thing in the organization. It is nothing but a reflection of the society. Treating them with respect, treating them with compassion, and also dealing with the basic act that for doing the extra role that they are supposed to do, we have to enable them. So basically to engage and to enable, the culture should be very empowering. And that empowerment should start from the very beginning, bringing up a girl child, giving her a feeling that yes, you are wanted, and also you are equal or better than a son. And in the growing up stage, that also an equipment should be given to the child by the parents that yes, you can do all the things what a person can do. And these days with technological advancement, that it is not the physical ability that counts, it is basically your mental ability. It is basically the output is not exactly what a man is physically producing, it is basically what he is producing or doing in combination with the machine. How good is he or she in operating a computer or operating a machine? So they are perhaps drawing a distinction between a lady and a gentleman, if really plus. And we have to come out of that. And coming to, of course, we heard about the quota and the reservation. Quota and the reservation is basically about promoting certain things per force. But again, if we promote certain things per force, perhaps, but sometime it may happen or keep on happening. But there, through the quota, there is a tendency to promote inefficiency, to promote incompetence. That should not happen. Maybe prescribed, like professor was telling Alexandra, that we have the for the election process participation of ladies. It is good that ladies are participating. But again, people with the basic qualities of leadership, the leadership could be different. Yes, for a leader, female leader, the more of compassion, more of looking after the entire constituency as a family, or the people orientation may be more. But at the same time, the task orientation, it is not true to assume that with the people orientation, the task orientation would go down. It could be moving together. So there, in fact, the reservation where we have the experiences, people are coming forward, but not necessarily there is a criteria. Of course, in, again, I will return from the debate on that. In politics, it is basically the quality we look for, who can mobilize more votes. But at least in organization, where the efficiency is the hallmark, where the competence is the hallmark, that we have to have the equal opportunity to be given, no discrimination on the ground of sex, no discrimination on the ground of that the lady or a gentleman. Without that, to give them the equal opportunity, understanding the basic nature that the extra requirement or the family requirement that they have to look after, that is also recognized in the work field, in the work process. Maybe not only the maternity, Professor Nayak told about the legislation, yes, legislation and all the things, there we are talking about the protection. But beyond the protection, the empowerment has to continue. Maybe we have to think in terms of not allowing him the maternity leave, maybe sabbatical for raising the child, and after that, retaking the performer who may be and who was a lady. Fine. But at the same time, the specialties are to that, to empower and encourage ladies to come forward, to take up the challenges of job. And our Professor Nayak raised two questions. Then, as I told, the first thing should be, if we draw a line of difference, it should not be the sex, it should be the competency, but while assessing the competency, there should not be a preconceived notion or a bias in mind that a lady has to be basically weak, or a lady has to be basically somewhere on a weaker footing. Without that, an objective assessment is needed. And when it comes to the basic fact that the jobs, specifically the services, specifically the hospital sector, that the special thing that comes with ladies, the care, the compassion, the affection, that perhaps is not available there, or maybe very few, so far as the counterparts in male sex are concerned. So we have to recognize all the things, as I always tell. Let us accept the difference. Difference is that, difference in us, Professor Alexander was telling, when a lady comes in, we look at her as a lady. And we have a preconceived notion that yes, as a lady, she may be physically weak, which may not be necessarily so. She has to be feminine. God created a lady with some things in mind so that the compassion, the affection and everything is built into that. And she is supposed to help in the process of raising the family further. All the things are accepted, all the things are worshipped. But beyond that, just thinking that she is an object to be showcased, not to be allowed to participate in the process of business, the process of making the world a better world, that is something is not accepted. Here also in India, we have the societies, which are some societies that, like in Kerala and down south, will find the matriarchal society. In the Hindi belt, it is mostly patriarchal, but we find in Manipur and Northeast, many ladies they do the business while basically the gentleman lays around. So with all these differences, all the diversities, what we have to promote is the equality in considering the fact that both the gender are basically creation of the God. In society, both have to be respected, and they have to be respected for what they are doing or what they can do. While we tell all the things, somehow the mindset still continues to be trapped in certain unwanted areas, unwanted things, like it is a shame to tell, but yes, it has happened in our society on the New Year's Eve. What happened that in Bangalore, no sensible person would just accept that. We tell, we respect our mother. We tell, we respect our sister. We tell, yes, we take care of our daughter. But there were daughters and sisters available there on the street that time, and on the New Year Eve, they were outraged. So those sort of things can happen. Perhaps talking here for women empowerment and then women emancipation, because emancipation we talk because they are perhaps the bonded. Even in religion, like in the Muslim religion, I'm not exactly the religion as such, but certain aspects where the law regarding the divorce, but they follow their personal law. This is something if we continue with all these processes, then the respect for the woman would be that. And unless there is respect, unless there is appreciation, talking of the gender management and creating a process, we have the law in workplace to prevent sexual harassment, we have law. We have the committees headed by women. Yes, those are interplays. We have very strict laws for punishing people, those who outrage the modesty of women or ladies. But with law itself, perhaps things have not been, and we have not been able to control those sort of incidents. That requires a change in mindset. And for promoting that mindset, we have many youngsters over here. We have people coming from different backgrounds, and in fact, here also, the delegates are from diverse background. We find good number of ladies, we find good number of gentlemen and youngsters also. Unless we accept the basic thing that we have to respect each other the way we have been created, and each and every person, though male and be male or female, have specific purpose to serve. And unless the purpose is respected, is recognized in society and in extension, the work society, perhaps these seminars will keep on happening, but the takeaways will be, because academics give us a lot of inputs, the research, what is happening around, and we talk of what should happen around. But for that, making it happen, what should happen around, you and me will have to change. And we'll have to change ourselves, we'll have to change our mindset, we'll have to change the mindset of the society around us, the workplace around us. Then only the purpose of these seminars will be really fruitful for giving us a better world to live in, where there will be equality and there won't be any discrimination on the or differentiation on the basis of the sex, and where the basic purpose of the organization's effectiveness will be harmonizing the interests, harmonizing the expectations of people coming from various backgrounds, including with gender diversity, to contribute to the cause of the organization to grow and the very purpose of making a better society to be achieved. With these few words, I declare this conference.